Go.
All right, man. My name is Trevion Williams. I'm in the class of 2018, 17 years old. I was born and raised in Chicago, Illinois. Right now, I live in Michigan, Detroit, Michigan. So, man, just trying to make a living for what I love to do, man. I mean, I just thank God that, you know, I have the gifts to play basketball. You know, it really saved me. You know what I'm saying? Chicago is bad. Chicago is beautiful, you know what I'm saying? But it also has its, like, bad places and bad areas. So, you know, where I lived at, it was just, you know, just it was a bad influence on me. So my dad, you know, he was a good basketball player back in the day. And he kind of taught me, you know, he led me on to play basketball. He made me start, like, loving the game. And then my September 20th, my uncle passed, Taiwan Lewis. He passed away. That was one of my favorite people to talk to, motivated me, just not just in basketball, but just in life, period. You know what I'm saying? I just, you know, thank God for him also, you know, so he gone, but never forgotten. He pushed me away to Chicago, to Michigan, you know what I'm saying? And he influenced me, you know, to work harder every day. So, once he passed, I wanted to get away. I wanted to get away from Chicago, you know, because of the vice level. So I moved to Michigan with my uncle Curtis Lewis, and I moved with him. So after moving with him, you know, I kind of blew up in Michigan after a high tournament.
So how did you think you blowed up in Michigan? When you first came here, what made you blow up?
So we have a teacher here, Ms. Valetti. I think it's her brother, I'm not sure, but she introduced me to somebody she knows, Coach Mike Valetti. He's the coach of the Michigan Mustangs. Michigan Mustangs was one of the big, you know, big teams in Michigan. You know, they had Draymond and Denzel Valentine, those type of guys. You know, they played for Michigan, Michigan Mustangs. So I figured, you know, why not give it a try? And I figured, why not give it a try? I played one or two tournaments with Coach Valetti, and ever since then, you know, my name just been out there. So, you know, I appreciate him a lot. He really put me out there. He exposed me to, you know, not just Michigan, but to the world, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, I ain't looking for, you know, high records, you know what I'm saying? But I just want to be great, you know what I'm saying? So many NBA players, you know, they so good right now, they well known right now, but back in high school, you know what I'm saying, nobody was ranked, all that stuff. But rankings just don't mean nothing, man. And I appreciate Coach for, you know, exposing me to not just Michigan, but to the world, like I said. So he was the main reason why my name got out there.
So would you rather, like, now, you know how Detroit got the violence here, like same as Chicago. Which one would you rather stay? You'll stay here or Chicago, back in all time?
That's a hard question. I definitely miss Chicago, you know, that's where all my family is. I miss everybody down there. You know, they all of them supported me, came to my games and all that. And Michigan here is different. The school types is different, you know what I'm saying? In Chicago, it was like a connection, but it was, you know, I went to all boys, it was a connection, but it wasn't like it is here, you know what I'm saying? I'm here now, I feel safe, you know, I can play the game that I love in peace. Just the school I go to, you know what I'm saying, it's just, we all a family here. You know what I'm saying? We all a family. And I take great pride in the school.
Okay. So, I remember last year, you had an injury. Would you like to speak on that?
Yeah, we first round in the playoffs, we played Hamtramck. We would have moved on to the semifinals, the quarterfinals. And of course, you know, right at the tip off, got my leg popped. So, I mean, that was hard to deal with. Of course, my team, you know, they was looking for me to, you know, lead them to the championship, districts, and all that stuff. But, you know what I'm saying, guys got to play for me. You know, I ain't saying, I guess, what I'm saying is that, like, I think, or something, you know, like, seventh grade, I remember getting in trouble. She came to school and she whooped me in front of the whole class. Because I got in trouble for shooting paper balls in the garbage can. You know, I said it was just basketball was just addictive. Like it was just addictive, and I just that's just something I love to do. And like growing up, you know, I got a little older. Growing up, I was always good and always had skill, but I never could show it because you know, I was that little chubby kid, little chubby fat kid. I just never could show it.
Do you have any like younger pictures of you, like playing basketball or anything?
I think this is about sixth grade. No, it's about fifth grade. I learned how to palm the ball. I learned to palm the ball. Of course, I was always the big kid, tallest kid in my class, so that was an advantage I had, so it was always good.
So the thing about height, like, what do you think, like, you started, like, growing?
I was always big. I was always the biggest kid in the class. People just always think I was grown. It was crazy to me because, you know what I'm saying, I'm young. My feet was always big. I wear a size 18 now. I was just big. Like, everything was bigger than my age, basically. You know what I'm saying? I was always the biggest kid. And I think that's what, you know, what separates me from other players. I'm young.
How tall are you now?
6'9". Yeah, so I mean, I started growing, like seriously, about sixth grade, seventh grade. I was in seventh grade, I was about 6'2", maybe. Eighth grade, I grew about an inch. Freshman year, I was about 6'4". I played at Mount Carmel. We went 26-0. We was the league conference champs, so that was good. I moved to Michigan sophomore year, September 2015, I think that was. Yeah, and I grew about 2 inches, so I was about 6'6". Sophomore year, going into junior year, I grew another inch, I was 6'7". Then I grew another inch over the summer playing with Coach Mike Filetti, then I went to 6'8". Over this summer, you know, I'm 6'9 now, so I just thank God for my height, my length, everything, because that allows me to, you know, play as hard as I can, so.
Catching up, we just laugh about it. Can't describe what my life is like. The night, waking up, the public statements about my private life. I've been quiet nights, but you can rest assured that my mind is right. Get no sick days, I leave for like 3 months.
Ranking-wise?
I'm not for sure for the rankings. You know, I injured my foot last year. All my rankings went down. And it was like first team, all state, stuff like that. I know I wasn't making it, so I wasn't surprised because, you know, when you get injured, you know, that's just the stuff you got to deal with.
So,
but I feel like it's my job, you know, to work even harder, you know, this year for this senior year. So, you know, I ain't got to worry about all that. I really don't care about ranking, but you know, I still want to, you know, work as hard as I can. And if I do get up there, then so be it. But I'm still gonna work and do what I gotta do to, you know, be prepared for next year. So.
I seen like how your ranking dropped from off of ESPN, like the ESPN ranking, like the top 100,
yeah.
Like the ranking had dropped. What do you think about it? Like, were you like upset? What was your emotion?
I wasn't upset. You know, I used it as motivation. I went to all these camps, top 100 camps. And just, you know, I went to a lot of, like, showcases and stuff like that. And I couldn't play, like, I couldn't play how I wanted to because my, you know, my foot was injured. And I don't want to keep using that as an excuse, but I went to top 100. I went to, you know, Michigan Elite 25, went to that camp. Well, the reason why I can't believe it's like a workout clinic. I played in all these camps and I couldn't play how I wanted to because my foot was, you know, messing with me. It was, you know, kind of confused me if I should play or not. So I couldn't do the things that I wanted to. Like, I played EYBL. Everything, man. It was sad because, you know, everybody was looking forward to me, you know, playing hard, you know, doing what I love to do. And I couldn't show it because my foot, so.
How was your relationship with Gabe Brown?
Man, Gabe, that's my brother, man. I definitely say he's my brother. Me and Gabe played Michigan Mustangs. I met him from Coach Mike Folletti. And ever since then, ever since one season of Michigan Mustangs, one summer, we played. Ever since that one summer we played, and ever since then he's just been close. And so we always had that chemistry on the court. It would have been nice to even go to the same college, but, you know, even though we're not in the same college, you know, I still support him every way. So that's definitely my brother. So
another term for Pete. I noticed how you said things about college. I seen on like Twitter, social media that you had committed to Purdue. Anything to say about that?
Well, with Purdue, I went to visit Michigan State. I think probably about three times. You know what I'm saying? I went to Xavier probably four or five times. I went to Purdue twice, and I just fell in love ever since. I was looking for, during my recruiting process, I was looking for a place I can call home. And I really just appreciate Purdue for, you know, just making me feel like it's home. I played up in the gym with the guys, I did, you know, little stuff like that. And they just, you know, they showed me a good time. You know, Purdue is 2 hours away from home, which is Chicago. You know, my family can come up, watch me play, stuff like that. So it all just came together and worked out for me. And I'm glad
Like, pull up the tweet on when you committed, the night you had committed.
Definitely.
I see it, that the retweets, likes have blew up. How do you feel like it went that night? How was that night? Do you feel like that night was special for you, that whole day?
That night was very special. You know, it made me do a lot of thinking. Just about the next chapter I'm about to go in. It was a long, dark thought process. I had some long talks with my mom, my dad, my uncle. There's people who've been there for me, you know, through this whole journey, through this whole process. And I just, you know, I thank God for them, appreciate them a lot. But it made me do a lot of thinking, and I was very satisfied with my decision. So you see the first one on to comment, to reply. My boy Gabe.
Season like around the corner. Do you feel like this would be like, I want to say like, do you feel like does it still feel like the beginning for you?
You always want to take a step back. You always want to regroup, you know, everything that you learn, just everything that you know, the skills, everything. You always want to regroup and gather yourself. And I just, you know, this is the last ride. I'm a senior now. Last ride to the, I'm trying to make it to the breads. So it's the last time, last chance I get to do this. So I want to make it, you know, special. Everybody in the school, they believe in me. Coaches, ADs, teachers, they all believe in me. Just my mom, she believed in me the most. I appreciate everybody, you know, and I feel like I'm gonna do something real special this season. Bad season.
Oh. Alright.
I'm about to go home with ice though. Man. Your ice bath.
What is tryout?
Oh. Huh?
Trials are instead of 13, bro. Hey, I'm not going.
See me?
All our girls, bro. Man. All our girls gotta get t-shirts with our fucking numbers on it.
God.
Okay,
we gotta get our number first.
I'm really gonna go by size.
I'm getting 12 or 15.
When am I back?
I wanna get numbers.
Man, you
look
sweet and like 8 or
something.
Depends. Yeah, I wanted 7 though.
And Kobe. I might get
5. Real shit, bro.
It only depends on
who,
like.
Oh, shit. Check this out.
We don't get the picture. Come on, man. That's what we do, man. All right, man.
Hey, these bitches.
Oh, man, I'm repping the dude everywhere I go. Repping the dude, man.
They look nasty, but they good.
Look, you
want to be here. Let me get it. Turn around.
Get it inside. Come on now.
Y'all warmed up. Get the goosebumps off.
I ain't gonna say much because you already know what's happening.
Man, stay tuned, man. Part 2, part 3 coming soon.
It's on the way.
What it is?
It's on the way.